We only learn how to read prakriti through the pulse and vikriti through the pulse. And majority, almost every student knows his or her prakriti. Then since yesterday we are learning how to read organ pulse. And I was amazed, majority of the students, their organ pulse reading was accurate. Like colon is low, lungs are positive, plus. Weak organ has a plus sign, weak organ has a minus sign and strong organ has a plus sign. So now we have to evaluate only negative sign organ. Positive is healthy, there is no need to worry about it. So how we can interpret the colon pulse? Colon pulse on the right hand side, under index finger, superficially, is colon pulse. Colon is called pakvashe. Pakva means final part of digestion. So, it is a final part of digestive system where amashe, ama means raw. When you eat food, food in the stomach is raw. It is not yet completely digested. So, the storehouse of undigested raw food, undigested food is ama, therefore stomach is called amashaya. I like that word, very beautiful, amashaya. Then duodenum, jejunum, ileum, which is all grahani. Then ileocecal valve. Then cecum, appendix, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum and anal canal. This whole is pakvashay. It is a seat of apanavayu. The final part of digestive system pakvashay, there is a main seat is apanavayu, and inside the pakvashay there is a mucus lining. Tasam panchami purisha dhara kala saeva asti dhara kala. This mucus lining of colon is called purisha dhara kala. This purisha dhara kala saeva asti dhara kala. Even over the asthi there is periosteum. Kala is a dhatva shayantara maryada. Kala is a membrane structure. This is astidhara kala. So the colon does reabsorption of end product of digested fluid stuff. That is called microchyle ahara rasa. Then it processes waste product. It processes waste product, and then this waste product are prepared for elimination by creating mass peristaltic movement by apanavayu. Mass peristaltic start from ileocecal wall, then cecum, and this is segmented colon. Colon has segment, each pocket, and there is a different pressure which this portion contract, this relax, when this contract, this relax. That's why the food stuff is pushed forward by apanavayu. So the final part of digestive tract, pakvashe, it is a seat of apanavayu. Then there is the ileocecal wall, which is the sphincter. There is a cardiac wall, cardiac sphincter. There is a pyloric wall, pyloric sphincter. And then there is ileocecal wall, ileocecal sphincter. Sphincter is called Saushirya snayu. They are circular and they act like a sphincter. These are not my words, this is from Shushrut. Shushrut was a great anatomist and great surgeon. So according to Shushrut, Saushirya snayu here is ileocecal wall. Then cecum, then appendix. Appendix is called antrapruchra. It is remnant part in the growth of GI tract embryologically, that part is there. This appendix is called abdominal tonsil. Wonderful. We have tonsil in the throat to kill the bacteria. We have tonsil in the nose, that is called adenoid. They also destroy the bacteria, and when we eat the food, then there is a final tonsil is appendix, and appendix has a function. Appendix secretes certain strong pitta there, and that destroy the bacteria. And there is an appendicular mesentery, there is a rasavahini, lymphatic system. And the cecum is also big pouch, that is called secondary stomach. So, pakvashaya colon, the final part of digestive tract, it has important function of reabsorption of the fluid, and it processes into the waste product called mala. Mala is called kitta. Mala is called kitta. Mala is called purisha. Don't call mala as purusha. Otherwise, your purusha will become purusha. Oh no, this is disrespect to the purusha. Parthi puri parameshwara. Shiva 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 Shankara. Hara 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 Mahadevara. Oh, Parthi Purish, that is Lord Shiva. So, Purusha is higher consciousness, and Purisha is lower consciousness, which is Vikarma. There is a consciousness in the Purisha. When you have constipation, then you will know, oh my, something happened. That is very interesting. Kitta, then it is called Mala. It is called mala, end product of digested food, ahara mala, kitta. And sara is microchyle, it is absorbed. Ahara rasa is a sar, that is absorbed into the general circulation. And finally, pakvashe, colon, with the help of apana vayu, the colon mucus lining does more absorption of water, mineral, and this mineral absorption is carried to the periosteum and it nourishes asthi dhatu. That is why tasam panchami purusha dharakala saiva asthi dharakala, and that's why when person has colonoscopy or colonoctomy, large portion of the colon is removed, they get osteoporosis. 5,000 years ago Ayurveda knew that there is a relationship between colon and the bone. So keep the colon clean, okay? Constipated colon, constipated mind. Every person should get large, lovely, lucid two bowels, one in the morning, one in the evening. If you don't get, take Trifala. I'm not kidding, don't leave your home without Trifala. Huh? Yeah, at night. Oh, I'm taking lifelong Trifala because I'm a Vata guy. I need some help. I'm not hiding anything from you. I'm explaining everything. What am I? My Prakriti is Vata 2, Pitta 3, Kapha 1. My Vata is high. High Vata can create gas, constipation. So I need the help of Trifala. I take half a teaspoon of Trifala with warm water. And then, dun-da-dun, everything is gone. Then it cleans. And plus Trifala is a rasayan. Yeah, you can take lifelong Trifala as a rasayan. Yeah. So, mala, kitta, then wit. The word wit is vital. Fecal matter is a vital mala. If you completely remove the fecal matter, you will collapse. Some amount of fecal matter must be there in the colon because function of mala is purishasya avasthammanam tatha. Purisha has important function avasthammana, to give tone, power, coordination to the muscles of the colon. That is the function of purisha. So people do colonics in America. There is a machine and they put proctoscope and there is a plastic tube and the machine is doing irrigation. Whole water goes, whole water comes and you see what is coming out. Oh, then after that colonic people collapsed because all minerals are gone. It disturbed the flora. That is why purisha is called wit. Wit means vital. Wit means vital. So fecal matter is a vital. You should have good bowel movement, but that doesn't mean you completely evacuate your colon. In basti we do basti, but basti is not colonics. Colonic is a machine irrigation that is not advised by Ayurveda. Ayurveda say basti. Basti is the best. Basti is called ardha chikitsa. And there are so many basti. Anuvasan basti, niruha basti, madutailik basti. Then you can use so many other satala basti, oh very powerful basti. Basti itself is a wonderful chapter, we can learn some other day. I don't want to waste my time or pulse in the basti, okay. So, kitta. Because of kinva agni, oh my God. Kinva, you know kinva agni? Manthan. When you do manthan of yogurt, it is kinva. Kinva means fermentation. And fermentation is lactobacillus action. And because of lactobacillus action, fecal matter gives you mineral. Maintain your acidic pH. Maintain your pH value. That is why purisha is called kitta. Purisha. It has some relation with purusha. When you have sufficient fecal matter in the colon, you have energy, vigor and vitality. Mala. Mala iti iti malam. Mala means that which create plastering, clogging the channel. And wit, which is vital, but wit. It is little bit vital, therefore it is wit. So these are the name for purisha. So, elimination is the function. There are four parts of the colon. Cecum, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon. If you add sigmoid and rectum, then it will be the sixth part. Cecum has an important function, because in the cecum, food matter start fermentation, putrefaction, gas formation. Therefore, in the cecum, the air bubbles are created, and that is called poshakavat. Poshakavat. So within the GI tract, lower gut, because of fermentation, putrefaction, gas formation, colon produces gas, and those gases are poshakavayu. They nourish prana, vyana, udana, samana, apana. That's why most vital organ in the GI tract is colon. Man is as old as his colon. Colon has a great function. This is very important. So we learn colon pulse. There is one leaky gut syndrome. Leaky gut syndrome is intestinal permeability. Intestinal permeability, the mucus lining, the wall of the colon become permeable because of porosity of vata dosha. So apan vayu become dry, ruksha, khara and sukshma, so it create more permeability. And the lining of internal lining of the colon get damaged. Therefore toxins are built, that is ama. And bacteria, toxin, they start leaking. So that is called leaky gut syndrome. This leaky gut syndrome is nothing but pakvashe kupita vat. Pakvashe kupite vate. Pakvashe kupita vat create kati shulam, adhodara shulam, avastambanam, and other complication, arsha and parikartika. Parikartika, fissure, arsha, hemorrhoids. So you will see, when we were feeling the colon pulse under index finger superficially, the heart is on this side, this is kapha, this is pitta, and this is vata. If colon pulse is feeble and there is a vata spike, that means there are gases, constipation, hemorrhoids, diverticulosis or fissure. All these possibilities are there. That is the interpretation of weak colon pulse with vata dushti. So it will create excess vata in the colon, will create gas, constipation, diverticulosis, fissure, fistula. This is the interpretation of that pulse. Now, appendix has important function. It is like a tonsil. It destroys unwanted bacteria, and cecum maintain wanted bacteria. Plus, appendix helps the cecum to store house of good bacteria. To create storehouse of good bacteria in the cecum, that is the function of appendix. And whenever you have diarrhea, your appendix help you to rebuild the colon energy so that you will improve your absorption. That is the function of antrapruchra. Plus, colon has important function to remove the water from the feces, balance electrolyte balance, water electrolyte balance. Water electrolyte balance is the prenan karma of rasadhatu. प्रीणनम जीवनम लेपनम स्नेहोधारणम पूरणम प्रजननम 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 थ्री किड्स ओके प्रजननम प्रजननम थ्री किड्स नॉट मोर देन दैट सो दीज आर द नेचुरल फंक्शंस ऑफ सेवन धातु प्रीणनम जीवनम लेपनम स्नेहोधारणम पूरणम प्रजननम 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 थ्री किड्स वात पित्त कफ ओके सो दिस इज द फंक्शन प्रीणन प्रीणन इज वाटर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट बैलेंस इट्स अ लाइफ फंक्शन देन पीएच पीएच इज नथिंग बट एसिड बेस इक्विलिब्रियम एंड पीएच इज नेसेसरी टू मेंटेन योर धातु अग्नि You follow? pH is necessary to maintain your dhatu agni. If your pH is acidic, you will get pitta disorder. If your pH is too much alkaline, you will get kapha drushti. pH should be balanced. So pH is nothing but dhatu agni. See, this way to interpret Ayurveda, and then modern medical doctor will be happy, I can understand this language. I can relate to this. I am just giving one little taste that how to interpret this organ pulse. And all these medical doctors, they love. This is fabulous. Because I speak their language plus Ayurveda. Then they realize how great the Ayurveda is. How divine the Ayurveda is. So, Apana Vayu has important function. Then, to maintain bacteria in the colon, to help the digestion, absorption, assimilation and elimination of fecal matter is the function of colon. Vaya Apana Vayu. The function of cecum is to maintain good bacteria and do more absorption of fluid and salt. Salt is necessary to maintain your electrolyte balance and absorption of fluid is necessary to maintain your water balance. Cecum does that. Cecum maintain water balance by absorbing water and cecum governs electrolyte balance by absorbing salt. You will surprise, your cecum can create kleda kapha. Wow! Cecum can create kleda kapha and it does kledan of the fecal matter. That's why your kleda kapha gives you good bowel movement. Kleda kapha for lubrication. Now, how to diagnose this condition? Called leaky gut syndrome. If a person has chronic diarrhea, leaky gut syndrome, see this is very important clinically. Person get chronic diarrhea, leaky gut syndrome. And when person get diarrhea, there is fatigue, water electrolyte balance is lost, fatigue. Nutritional deficiency, calcium deficiency, iron deficiency, folic acid deficiency, B12, all these deficiencies are due to toxic colon. Poor immunity, because poshaka vata nourishes prana. Poshaka vata nourishes prana. Prana stimulate ojas and tejas. That is why when colon is clogged with ama, there is poor immunity. Then because of too much ama in the colon, person get occipital headache. If you get temporal headache, hyperacidity. Temporal headache is acid headache. Frontal headache is cough headache, sinus congestion. But occipital headache is a vata headache because of toxins in the colon. Skin rash, craving for sugar because person get hypoglycemia and joint ache. Because Tasam Panchami Purishadharakala Saiva Astidharakala, and Astidharakala is present in the joint. That is why rheumatoid arthritis begins in the colon. And if you want to treat rheumatoid arthritis, you can use Dashamula tea basti, Dashamula kashaya basti. In sama condition, Dashamula kashaya niruha basti, and nirama condition, Dashamula taila basti. That way you can treat nirama and sama vata, because all arthritis begin in the colon. So I am bringing anatomy, physiology. I am going to my child age, BAMS first year, and bringing you to the higher level, to the PhD level. Even your PhD, don't forget basic. We should keep everything on the tip of the tongue. Then you can enhance the horizon of your experience. Even autoimmune disease, toxic colon. Autoimmune disease, clogged colon. That is why colon pulse is very important. If you get vata spike under weak colon pulse, then there is a possibility of excess gas in the colon, constipation, gas, bloating, diverticulosis, fissure and fistula. If there is too much pitta, pitta will create diarrhea, dysentery, colitis, diarrhea, dysentery, colitis, hemorrhoids, bleeding piles, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, regional ileitis, and IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. Irritable bowel syndrome is a dual doshic disorder, vata pushing pitta in the colon. That's why IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, is dual doshic disorder, vata pushing pitta in the colon. You can feel through the pulse and your diagnosis is perfect. So pitta in the pitta spike in the weak colon pulse, excess pitta in the colon, colitis, diverticulitis. Vata will create diverticulosis, cul-de-sac. But pitta will create diverticulitis, inflammation of the mucous lining of the diverticuli. Then dysentery, chronic diarrhea, dysentery. Dysentery is called grahani. Grahani. Appendicitis, pitta. Hemorrhoids, pitta. And irritable bowel syndrome, vata pushing pitta in the colon. And if you get weak colon pulse with kapha spike, then there is too much mucus in the colon, there is too much ama in the colon, so there is a possibility of amebiasis, giardiasis, cystic tumor, and amoeboma, a tumor created by amoeba, amoeboma. I just diagnosed amoeboma through the pulse. Weak colon pulse with kapha spike. So my dear friend, what we are receiving here is so important. Forget all seven levels. If you just follow prakriti pulse, vikruti pulse and organ pulse, you will be great clinician. Then next year we can learn third level, fourth level. It's not easy just to learn all pulse within 1 week. I am studying pulse since last 40 years and still I don't know pulse. Still I am a student of pulse. Just I am being a chronic student, you love me, that's why I am here. Otherwise whom can I talk? To the wall? To the paper? Oh, nothing. So, any question you have regarding weak colon pulse, on the right hand side, superficially, under index finger, corresponds to the colon, and colon pulse is weak, minus sign. Then pay attention whether it is kapha site, pitta site or vata site. Which spike? Yeah. Yes, yes, dear. We are comparing between superficial and deep pulse under index finger. Amazing. And the moment you feel the weak pulse, colon, then look at the tongue. Tongue will show you chunk of ama. Ama. Correct. It is a vikruti, yeah? Correct. Correct.
How does our approach towards the management
changes? You know, amoebic abscess, because amoeba affect ascending colon. Giardia and bacillary dysentery affect more descending colon. And near ascending colon, hepatic flexure, which is a near organ, liver. So toxins of amoeba, they enter into the liver, they can create amoebic hepatitis, it can lead to the amoebic abscess. Then you have to treat the root of raktavaha srotas abscess with arogya vardhini, vardhini, chitra, kutki, neem, which is very important, and amoeba with katuka, kutaja, kutaja, katuka is kutki, kutaja, or you can use kutaja parpati, along with arogya vardhini, use kutaja parpati, and topically apply lepa gutika, which is called manjishta, chandan, Rakta Chandan, Manjishta, Lepam. So I have treated this patient, very good effect. Clinically, it is possible to treat amoebic hepatitis with Ayurveda. Vata spike, correct. Vata spike pushing Pitta. Very good. Why not? Oh yeah, Ayurveda treat any disease. I am the living example. Ayurveda treats any disease with a great success. Please don't worry. Yeah.
How do you build the lining again? If the congestion,
the lining can be built up by moti bhasma, by pravara bhasma. And guduchi, guduchi is anti-inflammatory, and to build up nice lining, you can use arrowroot. Arrowroot. Arrowroot is a good for lining. Then it is a pitta pushing kapha, then I will use treat kapha dosha and pitta dosha. I can use shatavari, kamadoda, moti bhasma for pitta, and for kapha I can use kutaja. That way I can treat. Our treatment protocol varies according to samprapti, eka doshaja, dvi doshaja, tri doshaja.